فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We are in the explanation of the kitab, Kitab al-Sifat, للإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله. We stopped at the 16th hadith based on the publication of الشيخ عبد الله بن محمد الغنيمان. الإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله said حدثنا محمد بن سهل بن الفضيل. So الإمام الدارقطني, he narrated this from his sheikh, whose name is محمد بن سهل بن الفضيل. He's from the narrators, محمد بن سهل بن الفضيل, whose tarjama, his biography, you tend to not find it in the other books of, you will not find it in the Tahdhib al-Kamal, Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi and the likes of it. So it's basically one of the singular narrations that, one of the narrators which Dharaqutni rahimahullah narrates from him quite often, and you don't find him in the common books, you see. But Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi, in the fifth volume, page 316, he says that he is a thiqa, reliable individual. So you find his biography in Tariqh Baghdad. His name is Muhammad ibn Sahal ibn al-Fudayl. He then says, حَدَّثَنَا Umar ibn Shabbah. So Umar ibn Shabbah. His name is Umar ibn Shabbah, Abu Mu'adh, and Abu Zayd al-Nahwi al-Basri al-Akhbari al-Sudduq min Rijal al-Tahdhib. So you can find it in the Tahdhib al-Tahdhib by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. He then says, قال حدثنا صفوان بن عيسى, whose name is صفوان بن عيسى القرشي الزهري, أبو محمد البصري, ثقة من رجال تهذيب. حدثنا محمد بن عجلان القرشي أبو عبد الله المدني, أحمد بن حنبل, يحيى بن معين, and other than them two have considered him as a reliable person. He's got tawthiq from Ahmad ibn Hanbal, who classified him as a reliable person who has high integrity. Also Yahya ibn Ma'in have. Others have classified him as su'u hifdihi, his memorization is bad. Al-Imam Muslim narrated from him 13 hadith precisely. All of them lakin are shawahid. All of them, he brought them, Imam Muslim rahimahullah, kulluha fi shawahid, as a shawahid for actual narration. An abihi, his father. His father's name is Ajlan al-Madaniyu, who is the father of Muhammad. And Imam al-Bukhari istajhada bihi. And Imam al-Bukhari, he done istishhad of him. الإمام النسائي رحمه الله said لا بأس به, there's no problem with him. Also أبو داود السجستاني did not narrate from him except his son محمد. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما خلق الله عز وجل الخلق. أبو هريرة said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said لما خلق الله عز وجل الخلق, when Allah تبارك وتعالى created the creation, كتب بيده, Allah wrote with his hand, على نفسه, on himself, إن رحمتي, my mercy, تغلب غضبي, it overcomes my anger. Allah تبارك وتعالى said this, and he had read this. So this hadith in front of us, based on the previous hadith that we took, hadith number 15, it has an additional wording in it that Imam Dharqutni brought it because of that, which is that the previous narration, it says, لَمَّا قَضَى اللَّهُ الْخَلْقَ كتب في كتاب فهو عنده فوق العرش إن رحمتي غلبت غضبي. That the previous narration did not mention, it just says that Allah writ in a book that was with him. But this narration specifically mentions كَتَبَ بِيَدِهِ, Allah wrote with his hand, سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. So that's the fa'idah that we take with this other narration, which is كَتَبَ بِيَدِهِ, Allah wrote it with his hand, سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Now, those who say that the yad is means قُدْرَة, this siyaq, this context and the way it's written, in the Arabic language, it is mustahil, it is impossible that the Arabs say كَتَبَ بِيَدِهِ and they mean by it كَتَبَ بِقُدْرَتِهِ. أَبَدًا, the Arabs don't use that. And that is mustahil, it's impossible. So anybody who claims that the yad here is not haqiqa and it's majaz, we will say to that individual, هَاتِ, bring with you, in the Arabic language, the Arabs saying كَتَبَ بِيَدِهِ and they meant قُدْرَة. In this construction and in this wording and this way, this is something important. And this is something that if 1,000 years went by, they will not be able to provide. Arabs do not use كَتَبَ بِيَدِهِ and they mean it majaz. Impossible. That's if we accept majaz exists. Or they mean the yad to mean قُدْرَة in a context like this. The same is in the one in Surah Al-Ankabut, ayah 45, where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ إِذَا لَرْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ. And you, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he's saying to the Prophet, Allah is saying, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو, Muhammad, you are not one who recites, مِنْ قَبْلِ, before, مِنْ كِتَابٍ, a book. You were not one who knew this Quran, and you didn't have its understanding, and you weren't one who knew. وَلَا تَخُطُّ بِيَمِينِكَ, and you were not one who used to write with his hand. Muhammad, you're not a writer. وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ, can never have, وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ, your right hand, it can never mean بِقُدْرَتِكَ. You see? So this is from the things that they lie and they fool the people with. So those are haqa'iq, they're really literal meanings. This hadith, also Ibn Majah narrates it, Bayhaqi narrates it in Kitab al-Asma'i wa-Sifat. They narrate it from min tariqi Safwan ibn Isa and Muhammad ibn Ajlan an Abi Huraira. Both of them, they do it just like the author, just from the same tariqa as the author. Also, Safwan ibn Isa, he has a mutaba'ah from a jama'ah of the ulama, of the muhaddithin, who've done mutaba'ah with him. Safwan ibn Isa. Who is it that done mutaba'ah with him? The ones who done mutaba'ah with him are five. He's got five people who done mutaba'ah with him. The first one is Al-Layth ibn Sa'ad. The narration of Layth ibn Sa'ad, you can find it in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi graded it Hassan al-Sahih. Ibn Hibban al-Darimi in his Kitab al-Raddu ala al-Bishr al-Barisi. And also Al-Firyabi in his Kitab al-Qadr. The second person who did mutaba'ah with Safwan ibn Isa is Abu Khalid al-Ahmar. The narration of Abu Khalid al-Ahmar, you can find it in Sunan ibn Majah, Ibn Khuzayma in Kitab al-Tawheed, Ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf, Al-Firyabi in Kitab al-Qadr. The third person who did mutaba'ah with Safwan ibn Isa is Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan. His narration, you can find it in Musnad Imam Ahmad, Ibn Khuzayma in his Kitab al-Tawheed. Also, the fourth one is Khalid ibn Quraib. He's one you can find in al-Tawheed by Imam Ibn Khuzayma rahimahullah. The last, but not the least, which is the fifth, is Abu Asim al-Nabil. His narration, you can find it by Imam al-Bayhaqi in Kitab al-Asma'i wa-Sifat. All of them, pay attention. Who did Safwan ibn Isa narrate from? Safwan ibn Isa narrated from who? Muhammad ibn Ajlan, who then narrated from his father, right? And then who then narrated from Abu Huraira. All of these five, they narrated it with Safwan ibn Isa from who? Muhammad ibn Ajlan, from his father, from Abu Huraira, marfu'an. So this is what? This is Hasan. This hadith is Hasan. Based on the opinion that what? Based on the opinion that is what? That the father of Muhammad ibn Ajlan, his father Ajlan, is a person who is لا بأس به. There's no harm in his narration. Because Nasa'i said that, right? Al-Imam al-Nasa'i, what did he say? لا بأس به. There's no problem with it. Ajlan al-Madani, the father of Muhammad. So based on that, this narration is what? It is Hasan. Because all the narrations go back to him. So it's just Hasan, inshallah ta'ala. Hasanun lakin lidatihi. The next narration, Al-Imam al-Darqutni says, حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو صَالِحَ الْأَصْبَهَانِي قَالَ his name is عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ بْنُ السَّعِيدِ أَبُو صَالِحَ الْأَصْبَهَانِي عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ بْنُ السَّعِيدِ He said, and he's tarjama, but you can find in Tariq Baghdad. Al-Imam al-Darqutni وَثَقَهُ He classified him as a reliable person, holds high integrity. أبو صالح الأصبهاني عبد الرحمن بن سعيد said أخبرنا عقيل بن يحيى عقيل بن يحيى الطهراني كان ثبتا حافظا You can find him in the كتاب الثقات لابن حبان And also طبقات المحدثين written by طبقات المحدثين بأصبهان You can find him in there He said حدثنا سفيان بن عيينة قال he then says قال أبو زناد hey what's the name of أبو زناد سعد سعد what's the name of أبو زناد what's the name of أبو زناد of what نعم كنية أبو عبد الرحمن he used to hate to be called أبو زناد He became famous for that name. His name is Abdullah ibn Dakwan, but his kunya is Abu Abdul Rahman al-Madani, al-Qurashi. Hey, al-A'raj. Hey, what's the name of al-A'raj? Hey, yeah, Abdul Rahman ibn Hurmuz al-A'raj. An Abi Hurairah radiyallahu taala anhu. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that the messenger said. That the messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ That Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, said. This is a hadith, Qudsi. يَبْنَ آدَم O the children of Adam, أَنْفِقْ Give. أُنْفِقْ عَلَيْكَ I will give to you. This is al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. يَبْنَ آدَم The children of Adam, أَنْفِقْ Give out. That which Allah has given you, give. أُنْفِقْ عَلَيْكَ It will be given to you. You'll be provided for. So if you give, Allah will give to you. فَإِنَّ يَمِينَ اللَّهِ مَلْآ Allah تبارك وتعالى's hand is what? يَمِينُ اللَّهِ Allah تبارك وتعالى's hand is مَلْآ This is what it says here. If you go to صحيح مسلم, You find it says mal'ani with a noon. And Imam al-Nawawi in the sharah of it, he mentions that this is a mistake, that it can't be mal'an with a noon. And that what is correct is mal'a without a noon. That's what Imam Abu Zakariya al-Nawawi says. فَإِنَّ يَمِينَ اللَّهِ مَلْآ Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's right is full. Saha la yaghidhuha shay'un bil layli wal nahar. Allah is giving. Subhanahu wa ta'ala la yaghidhuha shay'un bil layli wal nahar. Nothing reduces what he gives subhanahu wa ta'ala from what he gives. And he gives subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is giving is what? It is day and night. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdul Rahman ibn Sa'id, who is the Sheikh of Imam al-Darqutni, Abu al-Asbahan, Abdul Rahman ibn Sa'id, his tarjama, you can find him in Tariq Baghdad by Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi. And Imam al-Baghdadi, Khatib al-Baghdadi classified him to be a what? He classified him to be a reliable person. وَوَثَقَهُ أَبُو صَالِحِ عُقَيْلِ بْنُ يَحْيَى الطَّهْرَانِيُّ كَانَ ثَبْتًا حَافِظًا. You can find his tarjama in Kitab al-Thiqat ibn Hibban and also Tabaqat al-Muhadithin bi Asbahan. Then Imam al-Darqutni goes on to say in أَخْرَجَهُ مُسْلِمٌ فِي الزَّكَاتِ. Hey, look at this narration. Where do you find this narration now? Sahih Muslim. The hadith is in Sahih Muslim. في الزكاة, the reason why in zakat is because أنفق أنفق عليك. Give and I will give to you. أخرجه مسلم, الإمام مسلم brought this hadith out. في الزكاة, in the book, كتاب الزكاة. عن زهير. زهير here is who? أبو خيثمة زهير بن حرب النسائي. أبو خيثمة, are you there? أبو خيثمة زهير ابن حرب. الإمام البخاري narrated from him. And Imam Muslim narrated from him. Rather, Imam Muslim, by the narrations which he brought from him, are 1,200, as Hafiz ibn Hajar mentions in his kitab, Tahdhib al-Tahdhib. Abu Zuhair ibn Harb, Abu Khaythamah Zuhair ibn Harb. So, Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim, Abu Dawood, and Ibn Majah, all of them, they narrate from him mubasharatan, directly. They say, حدثنا, so he's their sheikh. Who? Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawood, and Ibn Majah. They narrate from him mubasharatan. As for An-Nasa'i, rahimahullah, he narrates from him biwasita, through a wasita, and the person who he goes through is Ahmed ibn Ali ibn Sa'ad al-Maruzi, rahimahullah. And Imam An-Nasa'i goes through that narration. The rest like him, what do? They narrate from him what? They narrate from him directly. Al-Imam Muslim, rahimahullah, as I said, 1,200 narrations of his. Huh? He even has a book called Kitab al-Ilm. Al-Imam Abu Khaythamah Zuhair ibn Harb ibn Shaddad al-Nasa'i, he has a Kitab al-Ilm, which I hope inshallah to go through. أخرجه مسلم في الزكاة عن زهير, يعني أبو خيثمة زهير بن حرب. Hey, what does it say for you in the Taba'a of Abdullah ibn wa Abi Numayr, right? That's a tasrif. That's a mistake on the side of Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman. It's what it's meant to be? Na'am. So it's meant to be wa ibn Numayr. It's meant to be wa ibn Numayr. Because Al-Imam Muslim brings it from what? Al-Imam Muslim brings it from two tariqah. So this is a tasrif. He brings it from two tariqah. He brings one narration from who? Zuhair ibn Abi Abu Khaythamah Zuhair ibn Harb. And the next one he brings it from Abu Numayr. So Imam Muslim rahimahullah, he has what? He has two tariqah that he brings this. He has two tariqah which Imam Muslim rahimahullah narrates it. عن سفيان بن عيينة. From who? سفيان ابن عيينة. So both of them, they come back to سفيان ابن عيينة. الإمام الدارقطني says حدثنا أبو محمد يحيى ابن محمد ابن صاعد قال حدثنا محمد ابن زنبور. There's a تصحيف that happened in some of the copies. It says Zumbu without Ra. But the Ra is his name. So there was a saqat that happened in some of the copies. حدثنا محمد ابن زنبور قال حدثنا فضيل ابن عياش. That's not right. It's فضيل ابن عياض. فضيل ابن عياض, the famous imam. عن الأعمش عن عمرو بن مرة عن أبي عبيدة عن أبي موسى رضي الله تعالى عنه. So فضيل بن عياش is incorrect and it's wrong on the copy of who? Abdullah, Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman. It's wrong. It's meant to be فضيل بن عياض. عن الأعمش عن عمرو بن مرة عن أبي عبيدة عن أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So we have here that Al-Imam Ad-Darqutni narrated from who? He narrated from Abu Muhammad. Abu Muhammad Yahya ibn Muhammad. Ibn Sa'id. Yahya ibn Muhammad ibn Sa'id ibn Katib. Abu Muhammad Mawla Abi Ja'far al-Mansur. He is Ahadu Hufad al-Hadith. And he's one of those scholars who mimman uniya bihi wa rahala fi talabihi, who gave a lot of consideration to hadith and passion to it, and he traveled for it. You can find his tarjama, his biography in Tariqu Baghdad. Who narrated from who? Muhammad ibn Zumbur. Muhammad ibn Zumbur, his name is Ja'far ibn Abi Azhar, Abu Salih al-Makki al-Sudduq lahu awham, wa huwa min rijal tahdhib. Fudayl Mu'iyad ibn Mas'ud, Abu Ali al-Zahid, thiqatun abidun, imamun rafi'u dhikri min rijal tahdhib. Al-A'mash is Sulaiman ibn Mihran, hafidun hujjah, walakinahu yudallis. He's a mudallis. Amr ibn Murra is a thiqatun abid, rumya bil irja. He's criticized of having irja in him. Min rijal tahdhib. Abu Ubaidah, he is the son of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Abu Ubaidah رضي الله تعالى عنه أن أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن الله عز وجل that الله تبارك وتعالى that الله تبارك وتعالى يبسط يده الله opens his hands لمسيء الليل ليتوب بالنهار ولمسيء النهار ليتوب بالليل حتى تطلع الشمس من مغربها. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala opens his hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the one who commits. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he opens his hand for the one who commits sins at night, so he can forgive him at daytime. And he opens, and he also, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he opens his hand also for who? وَلِمُسِيءِ النَّهَارِ, the one who does sin at daytime, liyatuba, so he can take his repentance, billayli, at night. Hatta tatlu ash-shamsu min maghribiha, until the sun rises from the opposite direction. So here, this narration mentions, inna Allah azza wa jalla yabsutu yadahu. Allah opens his hands. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he opens his what? His hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, in the Arabic language, yabsutu yadahu. This tarkib, this construction, can never be used as qudrah. It's mustahil. The Arabs don't do that. And it can only fall as a literal meaning. It can only be haqiqah in this construction. Why does Allah do that? So if nighttime you go and you commit sins, daytime Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is accepting your sins. And also the opposite. If you've been doing commit sins all night day, Allah is going to forgive you at nighttime, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there's a time it stops. Hatta until, hatta lilghaya, tatlu ash-shamsu min maghribiha, until the sun rises from the opposite direction of where it rises from. And Imam Muslim narrated this in Kitabu Tawbah. And Imam Muslim, he narrated this in Kitabu At-Tawbah. Al-Imam Muslim rahimahullah, Kitab At-Tawbah. And you can see why he would bring it in what? In Kitab At-Tawbah, because it's an issue pertaining to Tawbah. Who did he narrate from, Lakin? He narrated from Abi Musa. He narrated from who? Abi Musa Al-Zami. He's called Abu Musa Al-Zamani. Muhammad ibn al-Muthanna. Abu Musa Al-Zamani. Muhammad ibn al-Muthanna. An Ghundar, his name is. An who? Ghundar, whose name is Muhammad ibn Ja'far al-Madani al-Basri al-Thiqah. An Bundar, Muhammad ibn Bashar ibn Uthman al-Abdi al-Basri Abu Bakr, Thiqatun. An Abi Dawood al-Tayalisi. Kilahuma an Shu'bah an Amr, yani an Amr ibn Murrah. So Imam Muslim rahimahullah, where did he bring, who did he narrate it from? And Imam Muslim, who did he bring it? He brought it from Abi Musa. This is the tariqah he brings it in. Abi Musa al-Zamani, as I said, Muhammad ibn Muthanna. عن غندر. His name is what? محمد بن جعفر المدني البصري ثقة أبو بكر. عن غندر. You see? And what? وعن بندار. So he narrates from غندر. Both of them. أبي موسى. عن غندر. عن أبي موسى. عن بندار. عن أبي داود الطيالسي. كلاهما عن شعبة عن عمرة. Both of them from who? شعبة. ابن حجاج. أبو بسطام العتكي. عمرو بن مرة. We spoke about his ثقة العابد رمي بالإرجاء صح من رجال تهذيب. This hadith as you can see الإمام مسلم narrated it, also الإمام النسائي narrated it في سنن في التفسير in his تفسير and also in سنن الكبرى. But the narration, the tariqah he brought it in is what? من طريق محمد بن زنبور عن فضيل بن عياض عن الأعمش عن عمرو بن مرة. So here we have something we need to take him on board, which is فضيل بن عياض narrated from who? الأعمش, right? سليمان بن مهران. Did he not? فضيل بن عياض narrated from who? سليمان بن مهران الأعمش. أعمش narrated from عمرو بن مرة. عمرو بن مرة narrated from أبي عبيدة and then أبو موسى الأشعري. A lot of people narrated from فضيل بن عياض. We have here right now in our narration who? محمد بن زنبور. We have محمد بن زنبور. But there are other people who have narrated with him. So متابعة. Who is it? Abu, we have four people who did it with him. Four people narrated it with him. The first one is Abu Muawiyah al-Darir. You can find his one in Kitab Ibn Abi Asim, Kitab al-Sunnah, Ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf, Hannad in his Zuhd, Al-Bazzar, and Abu Shaykh in his Kitab al-Azama. The second person who narrated from Fudayl ibn Iyad, other than Muhammad ibn Zumbur, is جرير بن عبد الحميد. You can find his one in كتاب السنة written by أبو قاسم هبة الله ألا لك أيو كتاب أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة. You can also find ابن خزيمة in كتاب التوحيد as well. He brings that as well. The third person is شيبان بن عبد الرحمن. You can find his one in ابن مندة كتاب التوحيد. The fourth one is الفضل بن موسى الشيباني. Sorry, الفضل بن موسى السيناني. You can find his one in كتاب الزهد لابن مبارك عبد الله المبارك. Those are the four who narrated from فضيل بن عياض عن الأعمش. Now, أعمش is not the only person who narrated from عمرو بن مرة. He has people who narrated it with him. And there are two so far that I know of. The first one is شعبة بن حجاج أبو بسطام. الإمام مسلم brought him. أحمد طيالسي عبد بن حميد الروياني in his مسند. ابن مندى in كتاب الإيمان الرد على الجهمية as well. He brought ابن مندى in the اللالكائي in كتاب شرح أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة. ابن بطة in كتاب الإبانة. ابن خزيمة in كتاب التوحيد. الدارمي in كتاب الرد على البشري المريسي. بيهقي in كتاب الأسماء والصفات. Also in his Sunan al-Kubra, he brought it, Abu Shaykh in Kitab al-Azama. The second one is Al-Ala ibn al-Musayyib, ama Musayyab, however you want to say it. His one, you can find it in Ibn Mandas Kitab al-Iman, Ibn Khuzaymah Kitab al-Tawheed, Ibn Hibban in his Ihsan, Al-Baghawi in Sharh al-Sunnah, Abu Shaykh in his Kitab al-Azama. So those are the two people who narrated with who? A'mash, from Amr ibn Murrah. The reason is because A'mash narrated it with what? Ana. So we're trying to overcome that tadlis of Sulaiman ibn Mihran al-A'mash's tadlis. Also, there's another tariqah that Ibn Abi Asim brought in Kitab al-Sunnah. If you want to, you can find it. Inshallah ta'ala, we have finished now the chapter, which is إثبات اليدين لله تعالى. ta'ala, affirming two hands for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The next chapter is ithbatul asabi' lillahi azza wa jalla, affirming fingers for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. We will stop there and we will carry on that part for next lesson. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.